think we're ready now for pig glands. We're gonna start at the head, work our way down to the neck. That'll take us to the chest, and then in a different cut, we'll actually go into the abdominal cavity. All right, so this guy, it's gonna take us two pigs to tell this story. So this is a pig that has, here's its eye. Its eyelids are intact. So you can see this is a really superficial look at the face that with just having some skin removed. And that lets us see, this is a facial vein right there. So I don't think that's in any of your assignments, but it's a good reference point. And so this guy right here, right, that's one of the salivary glands. This guy's another. And then what's left of the other one, because it really sticks to the skin, you'll see that in a second. This stuff that looks like cottage cheese, that's beige, that is some parotid gland. There's a little bit of parotid gland up here, and that would have been laying on this whole surface right here. So parotid gland is one of the salivary glands. This guy's called the submandibular, which makes sense because the mandible's right here. This big cheek muscle that actually closes the mandible, it's called the masseter. But so we have submandibular gland and then sublingual, which makes sense because it would be right under the tongue, sublingual gland. Cool. Okay, now if we come over here, we get another view of these glands. So over here on this pig, okay, the skin was not removed, but the neck is partially dissected. We'll talk about that in a second. But in the process of partially dissecting the neck, we exposed, well, first of all, there's that parotid gland, and you can see how you gotta be pretty talented to get the skin off the parotid gland. So, and we have these little stick-me-outs here, okay, that's probably a duct, okay? And then you can see all of these, let me, if I kind of push on that a little bit, you see all these like kind of radiating strings? Some of those are gonna be nerves, some of them are gonna be ducts, some of them are gonna be blood vessels, right? This is that same facial vein you saw over there, and this is then that submandibular gland. So if we can kind of sweep so that you can see back to the other pig, this gland is this gland, right? And that right where I have the probe is the view that you got before, right? So now if we go back to the pig with a partially dissected neck, now what we can see is that, yeah, we have some structure here with a lot of tissue on top of it. This is gonna be the larynx. We'll talk about that in a bit. And then some swallowing muscles, okay? But lateral to those swallowing muscles, we have some more gland. This is thymus. So back when we were talking about the thymus over the heart in the pericardium, said there would be more thymus in the neck. So this is the kind of, this is where the T cells, the generals of the immune system, are formed and kind of trained. And so there's lots of thymus in fetuses, infants, and young children. This gland, okay, on right on the midline is the thyroid gland. And so you can see the thyroid is between these swallowing muscles. If we come over to the next pig, we have a deep dissection of the neck. And that deep dissection of the neck, let me expose that a little bit. We had a little sunlight problem here. Let's go. Now I'm going to use scissors as a pointer. In the deep dissection of the neck, again, you can see the nice thyroid gland sitting on top of this ringed structure, the larynx. We'll talk about that in another take. Right. And then a gland in the thoracic cavity. Here's a nice review of thymus embedded in the pericardium. Okay, right here. This is actually a lobe of the lung right there. Thymus embedded in the pericardium, and then you can also see relative to thymus in the